Loved every minute of it.
Adam, why is that baby constantly crying?
He can't stand the jerks in the coach.
I know this sounds like a ham talking. I'm the only one, living or dead, that ever wrote a Marx Brothers picture alone. I wrote two. They generally had six or eight writers. Two or three or four would get credits. But they had platoons of writers.
Hey, lawyer, you dressed yet?
Well, after a fashion, and a pretty old fashion. And I wish I had an old fashion.
I wound up with these two pictures and a tick. Because it was real hard work. But we became tremendous friends, Groucho and I, and Harpo.
I'll thank you to keep a civil tongue in your head, and not in mine.
Groucho was the one who never really wanted to be an actor, hated acting, but was the one responsible for at least saying, all right, we'll shoot this.
You love your brother, don't you?
No, but I'm used to him.
Chico never had anything to say. He was at the racetrack. Or chasing a woman. Harpo, he was interested in what little shtick he could do, and he did them well, and he played the harp. I like the Marx Brothers films because they gave me a chance to write a lot of lines, funny lines.
There's only one law in the West, the law of blood and bullets. It's either shoot or get shot. What are we gonna do?
Sue 'em.
Comedy is great, and comedy becomes classic when there's really nothing you could add to it to make it any better. You know, that's why the notion of say, colorizing duck soup so that more people will sit through it is, what are you talking about? Let's not put our foot through a Rembrandt here.
The last man nearly ruined this place. He didn't know what to do with it. If you think this country's bad off now, just wait till I get through with it.
What the Marx Brothers did, particularly in duck soup, was parody political jargon and cliche political attitudes and the power structure.
The country's taxes must be fixed, and I know what to do with it. If you think you're paying too much now, just wait till I get through with it.
They've always denied that duck soup had any real political overtones, but they were very intelligent people writing this stuff.
Your Excellency, our men are being badly beaten in open warfare. I suggest we dig trenches.
Dig trenches? With our men being killed off like flies, there isn't time to dig trenches. We'll buy them ready-made. Here, run out and get some trenches.
Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. Get them this high, and our soldiers won't need any pants.
Yes, sir.
They're being attacked, and every, like, 20 seconds, what they're dressed in changes.
Awfully decent of you to drop in today.
I was probably 10 years old, and that just blew my small little mind.
Then remember, while you're out there risking life and limb through shot and shell, we'll be in here thinking what a sucker you are.
It said so much about the fact that war is this idiotic thing that repeats itself over and over again, and the only thing that changes is the uniform.
Torpedo!
Torpedo, eh? Call me an upstart, eh?
Dictator Groucho Marx tries to rule a country with the help of his brothers in duck soup.